Okay, now we are again back to the workflow, how it's work, and we a bit discuss a bit hardware, and we want to discuss or take care about the characterization of the motor. That's the task of this hands-on, and we have slide for that, and we have to go through this slide because you want to know what is the important. We have to set up our application. Yesterday we use example file, that's easy way, but in real life you have to set up your power stage, then you haven't any example file, and for that you have to set up motor parameters and also some startup. That's correlate together because now we are discussing about a sensorless solution, and without HFI we have to define some startup. With the new project we can go to the new project part, new project window, and we have to select some type of application. For today we can select a motor control kit, which is our P-Nucleo with three shunt. Maybe I never touch the different between AHM 001 and 002. Different it's only that the second one contains also the power plug. That's only some hardware stuff, but without any influence to the code. If you select your MC kit, Nucleo, you will see some description or picture about control board and power board with the mark, good mark if it active or non. For some development it's good to know. Then you have to select the motor. With our example it's easy to work with some bulk running motor because you can find it in the default list. For today we will have some setup of motors, and you will find parameter of unknown motor. Then it's good to know what is inside the motor parameters, because we have to set up some parameters. First is decision if it surface mounted or internal mounted, if we have in the motor some anisotropy. The decision is that we have to know LQ and LD. Our development team set up some threshold that different higher than 15% define that it's internal mounted, and lower it's surface mounted. If it's surface mounted, my recommendation is to make some average and put it as the LS. Now we have, if we decide that the ferrant is small, then it's good to put average value. And what is necessary to put inside this parameter table? It's resistance. That's it's possible simply measure with multimeter. It's simple task. Then it's a number of pole pairs. That number of pole pairs define that the construction of motor can contain more windings around one mechanical round, and you have to make in this case 4 electrical cycle to one mechanical round. That's the ratio between mechanical speed and electrical speed. Then it's some maximal speed. We can limit the speed of the system. In some cases it's necessary not through the motor but through the additional stuff on the shaft. Then it's nominal current. This picture it's from the old workbench. I push for adding different units because this unit is ampere, peak ampere. That's not RMS value, but it's peak value. and it's difficult to find it, because in the documentation you can find, sometimes you can find the voltage or number of batteries dedicated for this kind of motor. You can find no load current, nominal current, maximal power current, stall condition current, and what is the good to fill there. It's quite tricky. If you know some nominal or maximal power current, it's good to put it here. If you know that there is also some condition that maximal current for short time, for example for 5 minutes or 5 seconds, you can use doubled current for that short time. In this case, it's good to start with the nominal to don't overstress the motor. And if you want to apply quite fast acceleration, then if you have filled well-tuned application, you can increase this current. But you have to take care about that in your code, because speed regulator have this bandwidth of the regulation, and if you for a long time apply high speed which require this high current, then you can destroy the motor. You have to take care about this limitation of the motor. Nominal current or long term maximal current, it's a good value of the current. Then it's some nominal voltage, it's easy to find it, and inductance. In the following slide we will see how to measure, how to find it. In the past we have also demagnetization current. Thomas already said that if you demagnetize your motor, you can destroy it. And in past we have there the value which can protect the demagnetization. In the new release, development team decide that it's not important and automatically take the same value as the nominal. But still inside the library there is two values and you can manually adapt it. And last one, it's a back EMF constant, which is describe how much volt you need for the some speed or vice versa, how which speed you have for some amount of volts. Be careful, our units it's in voltage, RMS voltage per kilo RPM. In some drone application you usually have vice versa, that kilo RPM per volt. That's the simple recalculation, but take care about it.